friends, Gurmeet Kaur here from Method Creations. Today we will see plazzo cutting and stitching. So let's start for the drafting of the plazzo pants. Now first of all you have to fold the fabric into half. As you can see, I have folded it the open side towards you and folded side opposite to you, or folded side towards you and opposite side you can keep the open side. Now first of all mark the midpoint of it. From this midpoint draw a straight line. Okay, now this straight line will act as your length of the plazzo pants. So whatever the length of the plazzo pant, minus 2 inches from it and add 1 inch allowance to it. So suppose your length is 40, 40 minus 2 is 38 plus 1 inch allowance, so that gives us 39 inch. So this center line will be of 39 inches. So note it down, this is the first step, marking down the center line, and this is your the length of the plazzo pants. Okay. Now what we'll do, we'll go further. See, now from here top you have to take hip round divided by 4 plus 1 inches, then whatever you have to come, whatever the measurement come, divide it into half. So what we have to do is take half this side and take half on the center line, right side as well as left side. So suppose it is coming 11 inches, so what I have done is 5.5 inches on one side and 5.5 inches on another side. Okay, now we'll come down. This will be hip round divided by 3 and from there you have to mark a straight line. Now draw a straight, now draw a rectangle completely like this, and finally our one rectangle is ready. Okay, and you can see in the pic whatever the measurements are written over there. And now from this point you have to go for crotch area, so take 2 inches extra from here, mark a point, and from there you have to give the round shape of the curve, sorry, of the crotch. Okay, like this way. Yeah, so this finishes the drafting of our top part of the front. Now this is only drafting. First we will draw the draft of the front part. Okay. And if you like our video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel. So now we'll move forward. Now what you have to do, from the point 5, you have to take draw a slant line. Okay, now this line will end to the bottom of the plazzo pants. Whatever the, now here see, I have taken the full flare of the fabric, the full width. Okay, if you want, you can do it less also. So what for that you have to deduct the from center line, you have to take the mori round on the both the side of the center line. Okay, so now you can see the total drafting is completed and this is how it looks. So now I have also kept a paper pattern of it so that you can come to know exactly how it looks. So now I am cutting first of all the front part. Now for back part, what you have to do, once again you have to fold the fabric the same way and keep the front part over it like this, and make sure in front of the near the crotch area we should have 2 inch extra fabric over there. So just see ki you place it properly and you should have fabric towards the crotch side, extra fabric. And from the top also you will need 1 inch extra fabric, so better keep it 1.5 inches. Like, see, you can see, hope you can see it properly. So from now this crotch area, what we'll do, once again take 2 inches extra, and from this 2 inches and from above you have to take 1 inch. Now draw a line connecting this point to the end point of the top, and this we'll draw with the crotch, we will be drawing it. Okay, so first of all we'll draw the slant line. Draw the slant line like this. And now draw the crotch area. Okay. Now here you can see I have drawn the crotch area right from the on the below part only, because it's a small size. If it's large size, the pattern will be different. That I have shown in my next tutorial. And draw the shape of the crotch. So this is the back part. Once again, where the 2 inch point is ending, align it with the bottom of the pants. And rest of the pattern, like bottom is the same, and back will be also the same. The thigh part will be also the same from this here, the outer seam and inner seam. So this is the inner seam that will be connecting to our bottom round. Okay. And finally cut down this back also. You can see, and it will go from here, cutting the crotch and taking the 1 inch extra part. Don't forget to cut it. Also better, what you have to do is, you have to remove this back part, front part, remove the front part and then cut the back part. Okay, so now we'll see the stitching of it. So for stitching, first of all what we do, we stitch along the crotch line. Okay, so complete the crotch of front as well as back. Here you have to do it double sewing. And after sewing it, please, if you have the facility of zigzag or overlock in your sewing machine, you can do that. Or if you have, you can go to the tailoring shop also. They also provide this type of overlock services. There you can go over there. And finally, the crotch sewing is completed, the front and back. Now what we have to do is align this both the crotch of the front as well as back in this manner, and start stitching from, if you are a beginner, start stitching from the middle. Okay, so that the alignment is proper of the pants. And if you are advanced level, then you can go from the bottom also, no need for coming from center. So now we'll start sewing the inner seam. After sewing the inner seam, you will be completing the outer seam. Hope you people like my videos. If you do like, don't forget to subscribe our channel and do share our videos with your communities, friends and family. Now after sewing this outer seam, what we'll do is, we'll measure the waist round of this band so that we can attach our elastic band to it. Okay. Now I have completed the outer seams. Now we'll go towards our elastic band. So what you have to do is, first of all measure the waist round. See, this is the part where we will attach our elastic. So what you have to do, take the measurement and take this whole circumference, the measurement of this whole circumference. So that will be your belt over it. Okay, so measure like this, the whole round. And then you will take the elastic. Now suppose you have taken this elastic width of 2 inches. So what you have to do is, you have to double the fabric for it. Okay. So the belt fabric in which we will be encasing it. Like this, see, you can see. And we should have 11 inch of half of inch with the both sides. So the width of the elastic, double it and add 1 inch 11ths to it. So that will be the width of this, the fabric of the belt. Okay. And the length will be according to the waist round circumference. Now first I'll be joining both the ends of the belt. Okay, so now it becomes one whole round of this belt, so that will be easy to attach to our pants. So start sewing it and then we will attach this to our pants. Okay, so that makes it easy. Now you can see I'm attaching it. Now you can see over here is that the right side of the belt is with the wrong side of the pants. Okay, this thing, I have done something different this time. So make sure you are doing the same way. Now start sewing it. Now this time what will be, I like this right side of the belt is with my wrong side of the pant. So while we'll be turning it out, when we'll fold it, while after attaching the elastic, it will be folded on the right side. Okay, now if you want to form, the look is different. Okay, by doing so. Now coming towards the elastic, first of all, fix the elastic, both close both the corners. So you are closing both the sides and making it a circle. Make sure you are stitching it 4 to 5 times so that it is attached properly. And now we'll be attaching it to our pants. So now encase it in the pant waist round like this. Okay, taking it like this, keeping it under the belt like this. See, and now fold it like this in this manner and come over that stitch there. The part where we attach the belt to the pants. Okay, that part will go inside and starts to sewing along this line. Okay, this way you will stitch on this line and make sure the sewing part goes inside properly and don't stretch it too much. Okay, don't stretch right now. When we start sewing it, what we'll do, we'll stretch our elastic a little bit and sew it slowly. Because here we are working on elastic, or what happens, the needle might break down, so it's better to sew it very slowly. Yeah, like this, and make sure the elastic is always on the right side, so that while sewing it, while sewing this belt, you don't have any issues. So in the same way, complete it, stretch a little bit of elastic, little, like not like you are taking 10 to 15 stitches. Then what you have to do, stretch this elastic like this. Okay, and then once again start sewing the belt. So by this way, what will happen, the belt will be attached properly and you won't face any difficulties while sewing it, and you can also watch the next video will be on the last size, the plazo pants cutting. Hope you will watch it. So in this way you'll be completing it. But you have to keep in mind two things, stretching your elastic little bit and sewing along these edges of the belt. Only two things will be needed, so that makes you can attach easily the elastic band towards our pants. And after this elastic is completed, after the stitching this elastic band, what you have to do is, you have to start stitching in the middle of this elastic very slowly. Okay, stretching it and attaching, so that what will happen, this elastic won't fold in the fabric casing. Because sometimes what happens, it might get fold because we have kept a bit of our the casing might be loose. So what you have to do, run a straight stitch sewing line on the middle of this elastic. Okay, after gathering you will see how it comes out. So now on this gathering you will be running the stitch. Okay, so sewing them in this middle line. Now after this, what you'll be doing is folding the ankle round. So go coming to the down and folding it like this. So here we complete our plazo pants stitching. So like this and folding it. Start from the one leg and after completing it, go to the second one. Okay, so hope you like my videos. And if you like our videos, please do subscribe our channel and don't forget to share it with your friends and family. So, see you soon in the next video. Till then, bye bye, have a nice day and happy sewing to all my dear friends.